Good morning to one and all. In continuation with our yesterday's topic, the fourth day on this particular day, we are going to start about something related to the health issues or human health and diseases topic. So in this, we will first try to understand the pathogen. Pathogen means organism like micro or macro, which is causes disease in human beings or others. So that is called as pathogen. Next, pathogen, host. Host. Organism which is affected by pathogen. Organism which is affected by pathogen when it or he or she develops the symptoms. Next, symptom, sign or character shown by host. For a particular disease, symptom, sign or character shown by the host for the particular disease. Next one, vector. A organism, vector, a organism which carries parasite from disease infected person to healthy person. A organism which carries a parasite from a disease-infected person to a healthy person, that is. Next one, transmission. Transmission. Movement of disease or disease-causing agents and parasites, disease-causing agents and parasites through different modes. different modes is called transmission. Carrier which holds organism that is pathogen which holds an organism pathogen in them for a period of time but generally does not get the disease. So here you are seeing certain definitions for this. First one is pathogen, organism which causes the diseases in human beings and others and which lives inside the body of the organism that is host or on the host. Means inside means inside the body, outside means on the surface of the body. On the surface of the body and which can create harm to the host. Now host means organism which is affected by pathogen where it is develops the symptom after fighting. Where it develops the symptom that is signature of a condition of disease. Now symptom. Symptom is a sign or character shown by the host for a particular disease due after infection. After infection. Vector. An organism which carries its space pathogen is a parasite from a diseased or infected person to a healthy person through different ways. Okay, next one, transmission. Movement or passing of disease or disease causing agents and parasites to different modes. We'll discuss what are the different modes. Next, carrier which holds a pathogen, that is the organism, in them for a period of time, but generally does not get the disease or does not show the symptoms of the disease, is called as a carrier. So please understand these definitions and look at definitions towards for few seconds. Now, so pathogen, already we have discussed that pathogen means also called as parasite. Here the meaning of parasite is eating on others dining table. The parasite meaning is eating on others' dining table. Pathogen enters to the host. Host means human being by God's grace. So So modes of transmission. Modes of transmission means entry of disease causing microorganism from a person to person or from a other place to the soil. One is through this modes of transmissions are the modes of transmission are one is through vectors. Vector means not the physics vector. Vector here is the organism which is carrying the disease organism from a person to the person. So these vectors can be female Anopheles mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito. Culex mosquito. This is also female. Aedes fly. Aedes fly. Pig, sheep, sometimes dog, buffaloes. So these are all the vectors, but mostly known vectors are these three. Most of the known vectors are these three. Next one, soil contamination. Soil contamination means soil contaminated with urine, infected feces and microorganisms because of water contamination. Because of water. Third one, water contamination. Water contamination. The above only applicable. Because of A, dust. Air contamination. This is because of microorganisms through water, saliva droplets, or sneezing. So this is how the diseases can be transmitted from a person to other person. So these are the ways of contamination of transmission. Ways of contamination or transmission. Now, from host to host, how? Host to host, that is infected to healthy through mosquito, that is vectors, infected person soil contamination, infected person contaminates water, or infected person through droplet method. So any of these methods of contamination or transmission, example, host to host is COVID-19 and also common cold. So this is how the contamination takes place. Now, what does the pathogen do? How many kinds of pathogens are there? Pathogen means parasite. this is causing microorganism or organism generally. So there are different types like bacteria, example Salmonella typhi, Salmonella and Haemophilus influenzae. Haemophilus influenzae virus, corona virus or COVID-19 virus, rhinovirus, etc. Next, third one, protozoan, Leishmania dolomani, Entamoeba, Histolytica, bacteria, virus, protozoan, fungi. Next one is fungi, ringworm causing organism, ringworm and other different diseases. Next, helminthic platy, helminthis, nematy, ascaris, Ucraria, etc. So these are the different pathogens which causes the diseases. Have a look at this. So, coming on to the pathogen, already we have discussed that pathogens are generally bacterial, virus, protozoan, fungi and helminthic. So in order to remember the pathogens, okay, B, F, H, P, V. Bafu E Pravi. Like that, if you remember, this will be useful for pathogens. Now, so what does this pathogens do? Pathogens attack suppose I live inside the house or outside on the host, on the host. This is the first function that, and what does it do? It alters the normal functions of host. It changes morphological and physiological functions of host. So pathogen attack host and live inside or outside on the host. It alters the normal functions of the host. It is also changing the structural components, that is the morphological and physiological, these functional components of the host, and takes control of the host. As well as it also creates certain symptoms as general condition, weakness. It also creates certain times stomach pain, certain times of one or more different characters, stomach pain, headache, anemia, that is less hemoglobin in blood. Certain times constipation, that is no proper motion, that is regularly, and sometimes next parasite. So it sometimes adapt itself. It sometimes adapt itself to. It sometimes adapt itself to survive in adverse conditions like pH, stomach, high temperature, body fever, that is called fever, high temperature in the body, and also liver, digestion by mucus. So it also adapts in several cases in different parts, and also it tries to overcome those problems and causes the, by coming to overcome, they causes the disease. Now coming on to the, this is cycling. So any health or disease has disease life cycle. First is infection. Here, entry of microorganism or parasite or pathogen into host. The second one is incubation or proliferation, that is microorganism taking control of host cell, host cell or host body and increasing in number, increasing in number of organisms, incubation or proliferation. Third one is manifestation. Manifestation. By host because of pathogen releasing toxin or poison or changing normal function of host. The fourth one is called termination. Because of symptoms and host neglection, there is pathogen. So this is the code for this is like cycle R I P M T. Incubation, infection, proliferation, manifestation or termination, infection, incubation, manifestation or termination. So this is how you need to remember.